Algebraic Algebraic Proofs, we'll be using these properties to prove that we are allowed to solve equations. We'll be writing a two-column proof, which always has statements and reasons, using these properties as reasons behind. Every two-column proof will always be broken up as statements and reasons. Just as in paragraph proofs, the first thing that is always written is always the given. From here, solve this equation. The next step we would do would be to distribute our proof. Hence, our reason will be distributive property. Next, to get x by itself, we have to add a 6 to both sides. Since we added 6 to both sides, this is the addition property. Now, the next step is sometimes complicated. You would get 3x equals 48. Justification for this is the substitution problem. Because instead of writing 42 plus 6, you're now writing 48. Instead of writing 6 plus 3x minus 6, you're now substituting in the term just 3x. From here, we would have to solve for x by multiplying both sides by 1/3. This is the all case property. Again, we now simplify this to x equals 16. This is again a substitution, because now we are just subbing in 16 instead of 48 times 1/3, and we are substituting x for 1/3 times 3x. Again, for every two-column proof, we must have statements, we must have reasons. The first statement and reason should always be the given. This problem, we are asked to prove that x equals 2. So our last statement should be x equals 2. The first step here would also be to use the distributive property. After which, we would add 5 to both sides. Again, to add 5 to both sides is the addition. This would yield 3x equals 6. Again, this is a substitution. We are summing in the value for 6 for 1 plus 5. And we are summing in 3x for the whole statement, 5 plus 3x minus 5. Now again, you can multiply both sides by 1/3. Since we are multiplying both sides, this is again the multiplication property. Finally, we get the statement x equals 2. This is what we are being asked to prove. This is yet again another substitution.